Good morning. Now in the previous lecture we discussed the fundamentals of unit vector, position vector and displacement vector. In this particular lecture we will study the vector multiplication, that is dot product and cross product. Although we have covered this particular point in the previous lectures, but still again we wish to take a review of all this with the help of PowerPoint presentation. On the board I taught you this particular point, but on PowerPoint again I wish to explain you. That's why it is covered again. Now what exactly dot product is? In the previous lecture I discussed you the vector multiplication of two vectors can be possible with the help of dot product and cross product. Dot product is taken in this fashion: A dot B bar. Many students do not write here dot while during the exam, so it is not a legal move. A dot B bar, vector A bar dot B bar. Sometimes the vector is written in this fashion, A bar B bar, but A dot B or A bar dot B are the one and the same thing. In order to avoid the confusion between the magnitudes of A bar and B bar, that's why generally I write A bar and B bar like this. But as this particular PPT is prepared with the help of PDF of the reference book, so I just copied the screenshot of this particular book and pasted here. This Matthew Sadiku book prefer the notation only A for a vector A bar, and vector B is shown by the book in this fashion B. But in our explanation generally I write A bar and B bar, but both are the same thing. But the book denote the A by bold, B is also bold, but this A and B are not bold. It indicates that these are the magnitudes as per the notations followed by the reference book. But you can follow this notation also, no problem. So A bar dot B bar is equal to A into B cos of angle between A and cos of angle between A bar and B bar. So theta AB is nothing but the smaller angle. It is very important, smaller angle between A bar and B bar. For example, A bar is something like this and B bar is something like this. This is A and this is your B. Then what is the angle between these two? This is the larger angle between A bar and B bar, and this is the smaller angle between A bar B bar. So we have to take the smaller angle between the two vectors in order to compute the dot product of two vectors. And also one thing you have to remember is dot product always gives dot product of these two vectors always gives a scalar, not a vector. So that means you will get a magnitude here but no direction. You will not get a direction after taking a dot product of two vectors, okay? So for example, A bar is given like this: ax, ax, ax cap, ay, ay cap plus az, az cap, and B bar coordinates are bx, by, bz. Then if you take the dot product of these two, then straight away you multiply x component of first with second x component, y component of first with second, third component, z component of A bar with z component of B bar. Because you know that in the previous lecture I explained you that dot product of same unit vectors is always, their dot product of same unit vectors is always 1, but dot product of different unit vectors is always 0. So how will you multiply these two? A bar dot B bar, if you write A bar here, ax plus ax cap, ay plus ay cap plus az into az cap dot, how will you write down B bar here? You will write down here B bar as bx plus ax cap plus by plus ay cap plus bz az cap. So multiplying these two in a dot manner, you will get this. Dot product is commutative. Commutative means as dot product is a scalar, that means no direction is involved, therefore A bar dot B bar is always equal to B bar dot A bar, no problem. But this rule is not possible with cross product. This is possible with dot product. This is a distributive law, and this is very important in this particular subject. Whenever you take dot product of two vectors, then unit vector multiplication of same unit vectors will be 1. Multiplication of different unit vectors is always 0. So how will you take the cross product then? Cross product of two vectors A bar and B bar is written in this fashion: A cross B or A bar cross B bar is equal to AB sine of smaller angle between these two, and this is the additional element added here. Now you can note here that in case of dot product between two vectors, there was only one magnitude like this, but no direction was there in this. There was no direction, only magnitude you get, no direction, because dot product of two vectors is always a scalar, not a vector. But cross product of two vectors is always a vector. So vector always have one magnitude. What is that magnitude in this case? The magnitude is this. This is the magnitude of A bar cross B bar, and this is the direction an cap. So, but how will you find out the an cap? An cap is a unit vector which is normal to the plane containing A bar and B bar. So how will you find out this direction? With the help of right hand thumb rule or right handed screw rule. What it tells? If you take a right hand thumb like this, then the outstretched finger, if this this curled finger indicates the direction of A bar into B bar, because you are calculating what? A bar cross B bar. That means you are moving from A bar to B bar. So that's why you move from A bar to B bar. Therefore the curled finger indicates from A bar to B bar, then the outstretched thumb indicate the direction of that cross product. This is same like your right handed screw. If you move this screw from A bar to B bar, then this screw will go up. So this will give the direction of A bar cross B bar. Suppose A bar is somewhere here and B bar is like this, then moving the screw from A bar to B bar, it will shift the screw in upward direction. But suppose you want to calculate B bar cross A bar, then you are going from B bar to A bar. Now for this particular cross product, you are going from B bar to A bar. Therefore the screw will go in the downward direction. So direction of an cap in this case is downward. Okay, so this is the concept of cross product. How will you calculate the cross product? The formula is this. This is the formula of calculating the cross product of A bar and B bar. First of all, you write down the unit vectors of these two. Suppose the A bar and B bar are expressed in Cartesian coordinate system. So which are the unit vectors of Cartesian coordinate system? Ax cap, Ay cap and Az cap, or Ax, Ay, Az same. One and the same thing I explained you. Then you write down in the second row the component of A bar in three directions, component of B bar in three directions, and you know that how to calculate the cross product of these two. Obviously you have to take the cross multiplication AY BZ . So how will you calculate the cross product? First of all, you write down AX cap, multiply these two AY and BZ minus BY into AZ. This is the first component. How will you calculate the second component along AY cap? Write down AY here, then inside this bracket you cross multiply ax minus bz minus bx minus az. But in the second product, if you want to take a plus sign here, then first of all multiply az into bx and ax into bz later on. Then you can write here plus. Otherwise, if you want to write here minus, then the same rule you apply. What is that rule? In order to compute the ay cap components with this, then you leave this particular column, multiply ax minus bz here, you write down here ax minus bz minus az into bx, write down az into bx here, then you will get the second component. Okay, and third component, with the same rule, you remove this particular column, ignore this column, multiply this two minus this two, ax minus ax into by minus ay into bx. In this fashion, you can find out the cross product of any two vectors. Here the vectors are given in Cartesian system. That's why here we have written ax cap, ay cap and az cap. Suppose the a bar and b bar are given in cylindrical coordinate system or spherical coordinate system, then in place of this first row, you write down the unit vectors of that coordinate system. What are the rules for cross product? It is not commutative. As it involves the direction, cross product of any vector is always a direction. That's why magnitude of these two, a bar cross b bar and b bar cross a bar, magnitude of these two will be same, but the directions will be different. Why different? Because of this particular rule. If you are going from a bar to b bar, then screw will go up. If you are moving from a bar to b bar cross a bar, then screw will go down. That's why in a bar cross b bar direction will be different than b bar cross a bar direction. That's why this product is, these two are, cross product is not a commutative. Okay, that means it is anti commutative. A bar cross b bar is always equal to minus b bar cross a bar. Okay, very important thing in this particular cross product you have to note down is this particular cross product of different unit vectors is next unit vector, you see, but cross product of same unit vectors, for example ax cap cross ax cap is always 0, ay cap cross ay cap is always 0. So what you have to note, cross product of different unit vectors is non-zero and it is the remaining vector. But in case of dot product of same unit vectors is always 1, but dot product of different unit vectors is always 0. But here cross product of different unit vectors is non-zero, cross product of same unit vectors is always 0. How will you find out the direction? If you multiply in cross manner, cross product of ax cap cross ay cap is always equal to az cap. Ax cap cross ay cap is always equal to ax cross ay is always equal to az, because the direction is clockwise. If you go clockwise, then you will get positive az cap. But suppose you are multiplying ay cap cross ax cap reverse, then you have to attach here minus az cap in this fashion. If you are going in anti-clockwise direction, then az cap cross ay cap is equal to minus ax cap, ay cap cross ax cap is equal to minus az cap in this fashion. So cross product uses cyclic permutation. If you moving clockwise leads to positive results, moving counterclockwise means anti-clockwise like this, you will get negative results. This is scalar triple product, means multiplication of three vectors. In this fashion, if you take cross product of two vectors dot with first vector, you have to use which particular rule? Somewhere here written, it is called as BCA, sorry, not BCA, back cab rule. You see, here I have written A bar cross vector triple product is found out with the help of back cap. You have to remember this formula. Minus is attached here, otherwise inside this bracket there is dot. Back cap rule. Vector triple product of three vectors can be obtained in two manner: scalar triple product and vector triple product. Scalar triple product formula is this: BCA and CAB. Okay. So the formula is, sorry, the vector scalar triple product formula is this. First of all, you write down component of A bar in three direction, then you write down component of B bar in three direction, and then component of C bar in three direction. Then you can find out the scalar triple product. Vector triple product can be obtained with the help of back cap rule. One problem is mentioned here. What is this problem? A vector A bar is given, vector B bar is given, and find the angle between A bar and B bar. Obviously, these problems are not asked in the university, but you should know these fundamentals in order to study the problems in units. So how will you find out the angle between A bar? There are two techniques. Either you go with the dot product or you go with cross product. Once you find out the dot product of these two, you know that dot product of same unit vectors will be 1, otherwise it will be 0. So 3 into 0 will be 0, 4 into 2, 8, because what is attached here? 3 ax cap and 0 ax cap dot product is always 0. 4 ay cap dot 2 ay cap is 8 ay cap, that means 8, 4 into 2 is 8, 1 into minus 5 is minus 5. So dot product always gives you a scalar, only magnitude you will get, no direction. So magnitude of A bar is 26, you know this how to find out. Magnitude of B bar is 29. So dividing the dot product by its magnitude, you will get the angle between these two. How you got this particular formula? Obviously, you are having this particular formula. A bar dot B bar is equal to AB cos theta. So if you move this magnitude AB on this side, divide to this, on the denominator side, you will get the angle between the A bar and B bar. So this formula is utilized here. Dividing the dot product by its magnitude, you will get the angle between these two. So cos inverse of this will be this. Alternatively, you can use the cross product as well, no problem. So first of all, find out the cross product. Once you find out the cross product, then find out the magnitude of cross product, then divide this cross product by its magnitude. You will get the sine of smaller angle between A bar and B bar. Then taking the inverse of this, you will get this. Here is a print mistake of the book. There must be sine inverse of, because sine of theta AB is equal to this. So sine inverse of 0.994 will be this. So as we cannot deal with calculators on this online lectures. Hope you all will try this particular calculation at your home with the help of your calculator. So today we will stop here. On the next lecture, we will discuss the fundamentals of Cartesian coordinate system, cylindrical coordinate system, and spherical coordinate system. Thank you.